All right, so before I start on physics, I'm going to tell you what I think you ought to be doing. You're going to be in here roughly an hour and a half a week. You have not 10 hours of discussion lab. That's definitely for the summer. You have about 5 hours of discussion lab each week. So that's like 6.5 hours. In a 4-unit course, you supposedly have 4 hours of class time in class and 8 hours out of class. Here you have 6 hours in class, and so I'm hoping that we still have you for 5 or 6 hours of homework time. So I kind of hope it doesn't take you that long, but I figure for the 4 units that you get for this, we're allowed to push you at least on average out to about 5 or 6 hours of homework a week. So if it turns out to be that, then that's fine. If it turns out, I don't think it'll turn out to be a lot more than that. How do you learn anything in this world? You learn it by practicing. But you also have to practice the right things in the right way. You can't easily learn a language, for instance. You can't easily learn Spanish by just reading Spanish and then trying your own pronunciation at it. That's not going to work. You need somebody who is an expert to help you at various times to keep things going right, to fix your understanding of things and the way that you're using words. And so practice is certainly what you need to do, but practicing with somebody around who is more expert is a good idea. At home, actually, practicing with a group. Do your homework with a bunch of people if you can. There's nothing wrong with doing that. I encourage it. I'm going to ask you questions in lecture. I'm going to ask you to talk to each other about these questions before you answer. It's always better to talk about things than trying to straighten out what you think about things. And so that just goes along with this idea that I would like to, the thing I keep saying here is that you should be practicing these things a lot. Practice means talk about things, not just do a bunch of calculations. Learning physics means learning to talk about, the physics is a description of the real world around us, at least a lot of pieces of it. It's a lot of the world is too complicated to fit into a physics mode, which is why the subject of biology even exists, is because you can't calculate all this stuff with physics equations. It's much, much more complicated than that. On the other hand, there are a lot of pieces of the world that we can say something about using the simple models that we use in physics. And so being able to talk about these things in a common English sentences first, also in the technical scientific language that we use. So that's what lecture and the texts are basically for, is to, for me at least, the way I think of it, is to introduce those technical terms and the models that we use to think about the way the world works. So I'm going to give you some technical terms in a few minutes, and I'm going to ask you to practice with those. Of course, the one of the beauties of physics is that in the end, you can calculate something and compare that something with a measurement. What did happen? It doesn't have to be a calculation. I'll ask you to make a guess at what's going to happen when I use a vacuum hooked up backwards so that it blows air through here. What's going to happen to the levels on those things? And so you can make predictions like that, even with no calculations. And so I'm going to ask you to do some of that today, just because I don't want to spend your time here calculating. But at home, you'll be able to see that you can do calculations on some of these things. So you can actually, quantitatively, you can actually figure out how big changes are going to be. So the end result of what I'd like to say is, don't just memorize small pieces of the of a particular problem. What you want to learn is how to use a model, all the pieces of the model, to understand something that's going on in front of you. Sometimes we will ask you to so you'll have to be able to use the models really well. The first one is going to be a steady state flow model for fluids. Air blowing across here, air is a fluid, gases are fluids, and liquids are fluids. So I'm going to blow air across there and ask you some things about that fluid flow. What I was going to say was, not only should you be able to use the models well, or use them, but use them fairly well, because there will be times when we have a situation in the world, and we'll ask you some of these, where you have to use two models and bring them together. You have to understand what's going on within one way of thinking about it, what's going on with another way of thinking about it, and compare the two. And so you have to juggle more than one thing in your head. So that's a little complicated. That's about as complicated as they'll get.